Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera, Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, and we are going to go to the Reef of Fallen Worlds to investigate this thing that the Order of Truth, or whoever wants us to look at. Well, let me see. Track down the murderer. Fulsome, yeah. Where is it? sorry guys, just... This is it. Salimeri, an old friend of the Changing God, has been investigating a gilded structure in the Reef of Fallen Worlds, which she calls the Anechoic Lazaret. Recently, someone seems to have broken inside and caused some sort of trouble. She asked me to enter the structure, find out what has gone wrong, and make it safe to continue her research. It's an ornate, gilded structure. She gave me a metallic eye that should serve as a key to open its door. Now, if we do this, I think she's going to help us with, possibly, with our device that we need fixed. A resonance chamber, right? And, yeah. Once we do that, we can head back to the Order of Truth, I believe is the name, and also ask them about this other thing for the, they know something about... It's not the murder. I guess, yeah, these are alphabetical. Wish they were, like, you know, in order of, you know, activity. Anechoic Lazaret, Sorrow's Prey. Yeah, we did that. Digging through the rubble. I searched the ruins even further. Oh, someone near the house might be able to tell me if they spotted anyone digging through the rubble. So before I leave, I gotta do that. Sorry, guys. It's a good thing I'm going through here to, like, familiarize myself with what the hell's going on. One of these things... Someone in the Order of Truth was going to be able to help me with something. So, let's talk to people. Let's see if Piquo has seen anything. He glances at you distrustfully and looks away. Did you see anyone... Yeah, did you see anyone looting that ruined house against the cliff? No, but I wasn't really watching. He nods at the cultists who are lurking nearby. Maybe they saw something. Fidgets. Alright, yeah, let's ask them. Barat. Barat just hums idly. Hey, Tazi. Hello again, beloved vessel. How may I assist you? Who lived in that ruined house against the cliff? A man. But we don't know his name or where he is now. He always took great care to avoid us. I think someone may have looted that ruined house against the cliff. Did you see who it was? Yes. A mischievous expression crosses her face. But I wonder if I can convince you to share something with us in exchange for our help. She ignores the startled looks from her fellow cultist. Will you tell us about your birth? My time is more valuable than yours. Yeah. halfway through a production of Gabraxi, the erotic automaton. Very well, I awoke miles above the world, falling to my death. You can't be serious, she says, blanching. Yes, no one could have survived, but I did. Silvertide. Clearly, she manages. None of you were lucky enough to wake up in bed, were you? She clears her throat. Well, a deal's a deal.
I'm ready to become even more heroic!
Oh, great. Just what we all need. We did see someone looking around the rubble before you arrived, she says, glancing toward the pile of rubble. Dirty children, orphans perhaps, were digging through the ruins. I believe they took some food and valuables, but we were trying not to stare. Well, good day to you. To you as well, beloved vessel. What about Geronimo? Just fidgets. I wonder if Rin had anything to do with it. Oh, the random nano over here. Here for an alteration, are you? Juno will take good care of you. Not there for that. No. I won't miss you, but I'll miss your money. So I wonder if we can ask other people. I'm sure they told the truth, but... Okay. I think these people might be too far away. Fairly well. You know what? Let's challenge him. If he can sit still long enough. You've returned, he says, his eyes locked on the invisible enemy before him. I want to challenge you again. Well, I never did before, but... I want to challenge you again for the first time. Very well, but don't misunderstand. The challenge hasn't begun yet, or you would already be dead. His fist lashes toward you. Jewelless kiss! Block the punch and strike back. Boom. Success! You bat his fist aside and aim yours at his nose. He lowers his head, dashing your knuckles off his forehead. I underestimated you, he says, an odd light in his eyes. That won't happen again. Tell me when you're ready for the next round. Why do you insist on fighting to the death? I fight to learn my opponent's most powerful techniques, he says calmly. How can I be certain they'll use them unless death is on the line? Alright, I'm ready for the next part of your test. So am I, he says, nodding gravely. But prepare yourself. I will not hold back this time. Dabiri's assault. You mean you were... holding back the first time? He launches a two-handed blow at your face. Scan thoughts. Yeah, he thinks faster now, but not deadly. Parry and counterattack. He won't see it coming. I'm not gonna make it. I'm already out of stuff. Oh, I did it! You lunge into the attack, driving your arms up between his fists and pushing them apart. One hand rips around the back of his neck and pulls him into range of your forehead. Crack. He stumbles back, blinking, smiling. You're ready. Huh. I'm ready. Well, have I passed all your tests? You have, he says. But I will remind you one more time, this will be a fight to the death. He draws one foot back, settling his weight on it. His hands come up and draw apart, tightening into fists. Are you certain you want to do this? He thinks, a short fight. One kick at full speed is deadly enough. I don't have anything left, but if I die, nothing bad happens, right? I mean, I just come back to life. Sure. Very well. The challenge has begun. He regards you with the serene eyes of a predator, chest rising and falling. A warm wind tumbles across the stones between you. He flows with it, spinning away from the ground. His foot slices toward your head in a blur. Time slows as if the universe is holding its breath. Cockatan kick. Okay, I've used my... I'm not sure. Yeah, I don't have might and speed. I have one might. So I guess I'll try smashing. Initiative smashing. Hammer of the Changing God. Probably not gonna make it. I did. Before his foot can connect, you drive your fist upward, smashing him beneath the chin. He tumbles gracelessly to the ground, choking. Time resumes, flowing through you, and you feel some of Aiden's inhuman speed melding with your own reflexes. What?
I'm ready to become even more heroic!
You have won, Aiden says when he has regained some of his breath. Finish it. Gain 2 experience. I permanently gained 1 speed pool. Maximum speed pool is now 7. Nice. That was worth it. I'm not gonna kill him. And rob this world of your talent? Never. I see, he says, lowering... Ooh, gold tide raised a moderate amount. That's a lot. I don't think I've ever seen moderate amount. Maybe, but I don't think so. I see, he says, lowering his head, troubled. Perhaps I should have shown my other opponents the same mercy. Instead, their talent is lost forever. He staggers back up to his feet and resumes training. Callister says, dearest, the man did try to kill you. The least you could do is return a favor. Eritus says, are you going to be challenging everyone we meet to daring duels? Never mind. Don't tell me. I want to be surprised. Tybier says, I do thank you for not robbing the world of his talent. This square is a better place for the sight of him, jumping about and flexing. That's cool. Alright, we need to like rest and stuff before we... Okay, so... What's going on with this? Bard and Lust, circles in red. That's the girl with the purple hair. So this is outstanding then? Find a way to communicate? Maybe I'm supposed to ask more people still.
Tone down the glow, lad. I have a bit of a hangover.
Glow? What glow? I thought the entire world was glowing.
Not today, it's not. Today, the world is pain color.
Nah. Advancement available. Eritus. Anything we can improve is skill. How about some healing? Why not? Oh, elbow grease. +5 bonus gained from each level of effort spent on smashing a quick finger's tasks. A little force is sometimes all it takes to succeed at certain physical tasks, or kinetic overdrive. Gain +3 might pool, +3 speed pool. Eritus is stronger and faster than other heroes. Than any heroes, really. After all, he's the greatest hero who ever lived. Sure, I'll take that. Oh, we got abilities. Fell swoop. 2 speed. Attack an arc in front of you, dealing weapon damage to all enemies who fail to evade. Sometimes you might find yourself surrounded and realize that precision fighting isn't the best route forward. Sometimes only brute strength survives. Show them the error of their ways. Target enemies in immediate cone, and then a hook. One character is a target. One might snare a target with a grappling hook and pull them towards you. A chain, a hook, and an unbalanced enemy, that's all you need to ruin someone's day. You throw a chain around your target and drag your foes stumbling within range of your attacks. I'll take the fell swoop. Wow, all this stuff? Let's make him really good at melee. Are we done now with him? Alright.
He's done.
This guy doesn't hang out over here anymore. Maybe Rin knows something. Unless he has that special song. Oh, it's you! What brings you back here? Are you sure you won't come with us? She looks at all three of your companions, and then back at you. Quite sure, yes. She doesn't like Calistige or Tiber. And I can't ask anybody else about the house, so I don't know what... I don't suppose loss of self has seen anything. Good, you're back. Talk loud. It eases the pain. I want to help you deal with that woman in your head. Good. She's getting louder. I just want her to be quiet. I'm not going to tell her to jump off the cliff. Would becoming someone else be so bad? I haven't asked this. Would it be... She gapes at you. It would be dying. If I were sick, would you tell me to lay back and let the disease take me? What are you thinking? She thinks, listen to her. I am not a disease. I am you. You already said you've forgotten who you once were. What are you fighting for? I don't know. She shouts, but I'm alive, and I'm fighting her, and it hurts. She buries her face in her hands. It hurts so much. She thinks, it only hurts because you fight. Let go. Be at peace. I don't want to tell her that. But who is she really? The ghostly woman asked me to look for women who resemble her, or whose identities are being altered by an outside force. When I find such women, I should return to the labyrinth and tell her. Loss of self is one of them. Kiyotawa is one. How many are there supposed to be? So I'm gonna see if I can find another one at some point.
I like your dress. It's very colorful.
Do you, dear?
Uh-huh.
It was always my favorite.
It makes you and all the different yous look like a flock of giant birds.
Your first compliment was sufficient, thank you.
Yeah, you went downhill after that. I want to extend this bridge. But there's nothing. I mean, maybe a pipe out of this Fifth Eye Tavern. So we're gonna go back, and yeah, so we're gonna do that now. We're gonna go to the The Anechoic Lazaret or whatever the hell. So with the magic of fast forwarding. Huh. Okay. I just slept here to get my abilities back and such. All of a sudden now we have this messenger. A woman appears. Wake up. You do. She stands, arms folded, watching you with a grim expression. There's been another murder in the underbelly, she says. A little mutant named Crooked Keek. Oh no, Folsom wants words with you. She turns to walk away. If I were you, I'd head down there now. Can I take care of the I'm gonna take care of the Anechoic. Crumbles. I'm gonna take care of the Anechoic Lazaret first. Because I'm all the way over here, thank you very much. And I'm still trying to click on the area map and go there, which doesn't work. That's a Pillars of Eternity habit.
Yes.
See? She knows. Okay, I'm guessing it's this thing. These are things we use for in battles or encounters. Or crisis, they call it.
Yes, now.
Random energy pulses continue inside the shallow depression. A glass lens lies detached in the center, but it will be tricky timing to get to it. Oh, without any antagonists, okay. Naturally. The cube thingy. There's those dancing things.
As you wish.
Oh, can we get anything out of this sludge? We got something cool last time. Nope. Muck and more muck. Maybe it's in there. Maybe it's in here. Yeah, it's in there. Sure enough. The eye key thing. This metal door is thick, heavy, and unmarked by time. Double rows of circular bumps run horizontally and vertically across its surface. As you approach the door, one of the bumps suddenly slides open, revealing a circular aperture. A few tiny waving strands of synth emerge from the hole. Hold the metallic eye near the open aperture. The waving strands whip out, wrapping themselves around the eye. For a moment, the eye comes to life, buzzing and whispering, getting warmer in your hand. The synth fibers make soft, fluttery sounds in return. After a moment, they withdraw. The door slides open, and you step into the chamber beyond. Oh, goody! Finally. We saw this thing in, like, episode 2. Oh, hello. Koro. Who are these guys? The corpses of Murdens. Hunched, bird-like abhumans litter the floor. Their wounds are fresh, left by blade and beam. The air smells of rust and blood. Koro awaits you on the other end of the room with a hireling. He's clutching his bandaged sides with a shaking hand. Even now, he manages a cocky grin. Took you long enough, he says. Okay. I remember who that is now. He's the one we met him. Right where we passed with the bridges, the digital bridges or whatever the hell. Hold on a second. And yeah, we talked our way out of that fight, and then we met him at the I don't know what they'd call it, the headquarters of the Order of Truth. And they were sending him and me, or us, to investigate that. And I guess they got here first and killed the Murdens. And here they are. Now the good thing is that they're already damaged, so if they want to fight us, we are freshly rested. And if there's only two, we vastly outnumber them. And Cal, he says to your companion, his grin half a grimace, I was hoping you'd make your appearance earlier. What kept you? Following our falling star around the city? What could have possibly been more important than lending an old friend a hand? Oh, okay, I was wondering, Cal. Calistes, in your case, she says, practically everything, I'm afraid. With a pained chuckle, Koro turns back to you. We made a slight miscalculation in assuming the Murdens here were the architects of Salimeri's troubles. After we punished them for trespassing, we descended to the next level to look for stragglers, but instead we found what drove the Murdens up here. Heavily armed and hostile drones. His hand tightens on his side. As you can see, we had a rough time of it. We left two dead down there. His face is solemn. I should have been more careful. Well, if we came here sooner, I wonder if we could have, gotten the spoils from the Murdens and whatever the hell else. Huh. Well, Gold Tie, can I help with those wounds? I was hoping you'd get yourself killed when you volunteered. Can I help with those wounds? Gold Tie, a tiny amount. These? He says, eyebrows climbing in surprise. Another thing I can't treat myself. Now, if you still intend on reclaiming this place for Salimeri, the drones are still down there. I believe they're infecting the systems with their minds, and they will defend their territory without mercy. Believe me. He turns his attention back to his wounds. Good luck. Quaro and Guin. Dead Murdens. Nothing to say, Koro? Mind yourself down there. Salimeri will find a way to blame me if you don't come back. Don't know how Koro will get out of there alive. I was way ahead of him. Alright, let's see what there is to see. Oh, you guys missed some loot?
Alright.
You know me, I'm all about that loot. 23 shins. I took them, right? I didn't hear any sound. Guess so. Metal panels and parts have been torn from the wall, as if someone was trying to rip their way out. To no avail. This Murden has been dead for at least a day or two. The lower portion of its body is missing, and its midsection has been torn open to get the viscera inside. So they didn't kill this one. Why do they want with the viscera? Or viscera, whatever. Examine the corpse. Burn marks speckled the creature's foul, leathery robes. Lifting these carefully aside, you see the unhealed wounds beneath. The Murden was probably killed by beam weapons, and none of the other Murdens were carrying any. Right, okay. They didn't kill them, the things did. Whatever the hell, those androids, the droids or whatever. This does not account for the other damage to the corpse. Flesh was torn from the creature in long strips, and since the Murden was trapped in this antechamber with its fellows, you can guess what happened next. You only confirm your earlier findings. The Murden was killed by beam weapons, then eaten by its comrades. Okay. Num-nums, you know, gotta eat and stuff. Oh, more.
Of course.
Almost missed that. Ooh, a gravity bomb? It's a cipher.
These ciphers are killing me.
Well, I got one extra. Gravity boom. Target all in small area. All creatures in range take 12 relativistic Ignores resistance, damage, and knockdown. Consumes action. Active one round. This strange, crudely crafted metal plate is lighter than it looks. A hole in its center glows with a soft yellow radiance. Two handles nearby allow the user to carry the device. When treated violently, such as being struck or thrown, the cipher's light hardens and gravity settles harder on everything in the vicinity. Our lore for machinery tells us the core of this device seems to have been harvested from an ancient ship by the infamous nano Amon Yao Guru. His legend ends with the cipher's harvest. Perhaps the vessel's last act was to crush this unwanted intruder. So someone could take this. I can give this to him. Eritus, you enjoy. Maybe we'll use it on those things down there if one of us doesn't get caught in the blast. Depending on positioning and such.
Yes.
This is the one I looked at already, right? Okay, so we're done here in this side. But this thing. I can interact there as well. More loot? These guys left a lot of stuff. Bedrolls or something. 14 shins. Is that them talking? Are they pissed they left all this stuff? I would be. Amateurs. Alright, let's interact with this.
Yes, now.
Whatever the hell that is. Ooh, it shakes. It opened? Oh, climb down. The chrome pillar descends as you approach, exposing a long shaft ring with snaking cables. Dim light filters up from below. Alright, so that's a way... That's the only way. Yeah. I just wanted to make sure there were no doors over here, and there are not, so... I think it's a good time to save. I think we're on 36. And 37, rather. Yeah. So, probably gonna have another battle here, because I don't think we can reason with these things. Although, you never know. Peerless. Oh, it saved again for me. The construct floats up to bar your path. Blood speckles its ridged surface. I guess I'll... robot voice? Halt, Flesh Walker. It bellows. There's two more over there. Quake in the boundless shadow of peerless, immortal intelligence of a lost age. Cower before me and you may be spared. What did you call me? Flesh Walker, it says, tilting carefully to one side. You are made of decaying meat and hardened calcium. You squish and click when you move. It is disgusting. Enough of these pleasantries. Leave, or my drones and I will smash your bones and burn smoking holes in your fatty innards. You mentioned the other drones. What can you tell me about them? They are my hands, the floating orb says smugly. That wasn't very smug, was it? Extensions of my indestructible will. Reflections of my brilliance. So the drones are copies of you? I gain XP. Not exact copies. Perfection cannot be so easily replicated, but you are essentially correct, Flesh Walker. The construct vibrates with frustration. Can that crumpled wad of meat in your head hold no more than a few memories at a time? I am peerless, a limited intelligence that spans the infinite valleys of time itself. Peerless has an ego. What are you doing down here? Great work, worthy of an immortal being. And even that is more than you deserve to know? Can you tell me anything else about what you're doing down here? No, the construct snaps. It is beyond your meat-bound understanding. Meat-bound understanding. I've forgotten your name again. The construct growls but does not respond. I'm leaving. Excellent. Do not return. We are busy here.
I'll remember that.
Of course, this doesn't mean I actually have to leave. I know we're gonna end up fighting them. Can we talk to them?
I'm ready. Without doubt.
Not attacking yet.